Hello. I hope you're doing very, 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 very well. Today, we are going to unbox and try on look at these boots. I will call them boots because that is what they are called by the maker, but they are kind of almost like high heel boots, but the heel's not stationary, you'll see. They're by Sorrel. Oh, it goes a little cute with a little polar bear. And kind of a black box that opens like this. This is a very angry pug sound. Looking forward to trying these bad boys on. So you see what I mean? It has a heel, so it'll have like, I don't know, I think legs and heels make legs and butts and stuff look really good. So you'll have that effect of the heel on your leg, your heel being pushed up, which I think is a really kind of flattering look, which is why high heels are so popular for women. But it also has the heel of a boot. I'll be able to walk in snow and ice and my foot be warm but still like get my heel fix. And they smell like very, very nice leather. I'm dying to put these on. Leather is a nice matte black. And this part, the back, are nylon. It has these little nylon strips, and the whole foot is formed leather. And I love how like, I like how this flares out. I think it's pretty cool and how chunky, substantial the whole thing is. Inside is lined with canvas. The eye holes are through leather. And the tongue is leather. And the laces are cotton. We have little metal eyelets. Well, I probably still will, but it won't be the shoe's fault when that happens. I have real trouble walking on ice. And I think all humans do. We're all trying to balance on two legs. This feels so good, though. clean, very, very nice to walk in. Snow or ice won't matter any. The inside's lined with canvas, like I said, but it still has a really, really nice leather scent. What do they call that kind of leather? Is it crazy horse leather? It kind of reminds me of crazy horse leather. That, like, it's not distressed, but that kind of like matte, rugged feel. It's very soft and smooth, but rigid, because it's not a steel. It'd be really funny to have a heeled boot with a heel, like a heel wedge boot with a steel-toed shoe. I wonder if that exists. I don't need it if it does. It's just the idea is funny to care so much about like the safety, but then also have a heel in it. Anyway. Completely unlike any other boot style I have, or heel style I have. Just a really cool mashup of styles. And I think at first glance you wouldn't even realize that they had heels in them, but they do, which just gives them a little bit of lift. I really like it. Let's put you down on the ground. You get a good look at them. You could picture like a cutout, which it could have. I wouldn't like it as much, but it could have like a cutout where a heel is, because you can see the foot is like here.
kind of remind me of, it just with the chunkiness and stuff, Doc Martens. Like a, you know how those like kind of chunky 90s boots are definitely coming back in this, or have come back into style. They're well lined, so they'll be nice and warm to wear out. Kind of like, you know, jazz up jeans. I mean, that's not a normal footprint. It would be wider if your foot was all the way to the bottom. But it doesn't need to have such a wide. But it like kind of flares out. I'm trying to show you with it on. It flares out on the side to give you more stability in like winter conditions. On the back heel part. But it like, it's very narrow in the back. These are super comfortable, no question. They're can wear all day kind of thing. Definitely gonna wear these around the house now. And outside, but I meant I'm not gonna take them off. I really like these. Very good, different addition to our boot and heel collection. I just love the profile of this, like how squared off it is. And these like three stitch separate areas kind of remind me of like Converse high tops a little bit. They're just like a culmination of the cool parts of so many different kinds of shoes. But I think because they're all like that same super dark matte black, it all like goes together. Oh look, I brought my catnip plant in because it was outside and it started to bud since December was so warm, and I was like, this thing is gonna hate it when the frost comes and it's not gonna be able to survive budding again. So I brought it in. So now I have catnip in my house, but no cats in my house. But it's okay. Catnip just smells like mint, like a really mild mint. Not like a stinky plant. But I will see you next time. Thank you for enjoying these with me. I will certainly enjoy them for the rest of the day and beyond. I love them. I love the chunky boot feel with the like kind of fanciness of feeling like you're wearing relatively high heels. I mean, they're like that. That would be the heel part. So anyway, I will talk to you later.